Championship. It's semifinal Saturday as we get set for game one. The 14th-ranked Wichita State Shockers getting set to take on the Illinois State Redbirds. Scott Warman with you. Welcome back inside the Scott Trade Center. And day three of Arch Madness, quarterfinal Friday, always exciting. But now we're going to crank it up a little bit more with semifinal Saturday. Let's take a look at the brackets and get you set up for what we've got going on today. Brackets are brought to you by State Farm. Wichita State, the top seed, will take on the fourth seed Redbirds, who knocked off UNI yesterday. 24th ranked Creighton will be coming up next as they will take on the Purple Aces of Evansville. But first, it's game one, the Shockers and the Redbirds. And we go courtside and check in with Mark Adams and John Rooney. Guys?
All right, thank you very much, Scott. And Mark, what a great day to be at the arena. The final four teams within the Missouri Valley Conference. We're going to see some great talent on the floor today.
Well, we're going to see a team showcase today in Wichita State. They've won 25 out of their last 27, 17 out of their last 18, and 9 in a row. Where do they belong in the seeding right now for the NCAA tournament? Take a look at Southern Illinois in 2007, was a number 4 seed, 27-6 versus 27-4 for the Wichita State Shockers. Look at the RPIs, very similar. Road records, one of the greatest road teams in the country over the last two seasons, Wichita State. Versus the top 50, a little bit of work to do, but remember, possibly Creighton could be on the horizon in the finals, which would even that at 3-3, and non-conference strength of schedule. Look at that strength of schedule. In my view, John, Wichita State right now is a number 4 seed with a win today and tomorrow, maybe a number 3.
And the only road to the NCAA tournament for Illinois State, win, win, win. Boy, they call it Arch Madness. We've had a lot of fun here in St. Louis so far. They're here from Wichita. They're here from Illinois State. Jackie Carmichael and company. The Redbirds hope to slide on in against Wichita State today. History brought to you by Coventry Healthcare. Illinois State has the lead, 36-33 all time. But Wichita State has won 6 in a row. And in postseason play, the Redbirds are 4-3 against the Shockers in postseason play. And the Redbirds are coached by Tim Jankovich. Jankovich has done a good job in his tenure at Illinois State, 102 victories, coaching in his fifth season. Greg Marshall is the coach of the year in the Missouri Valley Conference. He heads up the program at Wichita State, 5 years there after coaching at Winthrop. 109 victories for the Wichita State Shockers under Greg Marshall. Visit CoventryHealthcare.com for more information. As we take a look at our starting lineups, a presentation of SLU Care Orthopedic Sports Medicine Specialist at SLU Hospital, who can help keep you in the game. Jackie Carmichael, a double-double yesterday at 15 boards. And for Wichita State, Terrain Murray, he was honorable mention All-Missouri Valley Conference. He thought he could have been a little higher than that. I think his coach thought he could have been a little higher than that in the postseason honors. And he's off to a good start as Murray yesterday played a terrific game against Indiana State with 14 points. And now here are the keys to the game presented by State Farm. Mark?
For Illinois State, Jackie Carmichael has to dominate like he did last night when he dropped a double-double in the victory over Northern Iowa in the quarterfinals. And as a team, they've got to duplicate that effort, holding their opponents to 25.4% from the floor, and they're plus 15 on the glass. Those are the keys for Illinois State. For Wichita State, shock Jackie. Get him into foul trouble. Attack him and be merciless on the glass. One of the great rebounding teams in the country, Wichita State, is going to attack Illinois State on the glass this afternoon.
For auto, home, life, and banking, get to a better state. Find an agent or get a quote at statefarm.com. And joining our telecast courtside, let's welcome in Tom Ackerman.
Thank you, John. Wichita State is playing at such a high level. After their 24-point win over Indiana State yesterday, Greg Marshall talked about coaching confidence. He says he loves the type of confidence this team plays with. He doesn't want it to be cocky or demeaning or disrespectful, but he loves the way they play with a swagger. He said the key now is for us to defend, to play hard, play smart. And if we do that, things are flowing for us on the offensive end.
And Tom, this Wichita State team was selected the defensive team of the year in the Missouri Valley Conference. And if they had any trouble going back about 7 or 8 games, they had a few defensive lapses. but over the last 7 to 8 ball games, this team is playing as well as anyone in the nation. And right out of the gate, Williams is able to secure the tip. And here are the Shockers on the attack to open up this semifinal Saturday.
Shockers like to get it down to Stutz early in the game. There it is.
Stutz against Carmichael. Watch that matchup early. Bumping going on. Williams from the point. That's off the mark. And run down by freshman Nick Moore. Moore has had at least 3 assists in 20 games this season. Giving it up to Tyler Brown. Easy over to Moore.
Early on, can Jackie Carmichael get Stutz in foul trouble? There's your one-on-one matchup. 32 versus Stutz 41.
Carmichael too long with that shot. And Ben Smith is there for Wichita State. So Ray Murray, number 23. Smith at the point. And number 5 is Demetric Williams. Done a good job at taking care of the basketball for the Shockers. Smith. And in a fight for the rebound, the loose ball. That belongs to Tyler Brown of Illinois State. On the other end, Illinois State gets the follow by Carmichael, who went flying through the air for the dunk.
Jackie Carmichael has to dominate. That was domination.
And here is Torrey Murray. Murray into the lane, and he is cut off by Eakey. Illinois State giving it away to John Ragland, and he scores it. No, no basket. Ragland is called for the foul.
It is physical and aggressive early. Watch Torrey Murray as he gets screened by Nick Moore and goes right down. And then Jackie Carmichael follows that up with Murray on the ground. Nobody to block off. And Carmichael with the dunk.
Tyler Brown off the miss. Carmichael came flying through to give Illinois State the 2-point lead they have now. Brown backing away with the dribble. Now the freshman Nick Moore.
You feel like Illinois State is sending a message. We are here to play against the number 14 team in the country.
That rims off to Garrett Stutz. Stutz at the point. Carmichael is watching him. And off the glass. Murray's first field goal of the day. He's averaging 12.1 points a game.
He has upped the ante for Wichita State. We've always known he's a rangy defender with a good mid-range game. He seems more focused now than he has throughout the last 2 seasons.
Here's Brown. Count it. Tyler Brown, averaging 12-6 a game, gets his first basket.
Tyler Brown, for Illinois State to win this game, he's got to score. Averages almost 13 a game. He's got to score for Illinois State to have a chance.
Red Birds are 2 out of 5 from the field. The Shockers 1 for 3 so far. Here's Ragland. Long range and in there.
One word to describe Joel Ragland. Winner.
All first team. First team All-Missouri Valley Conference. Ragland with a 3. And now Ike on the other end. Can't answer the 3. And on a bounce, here comes Williams. He's going to circle out. Smith is at the point. Low, wide open. Stutz just banks it in.
I love it when a big guy catches, keeps the ball elevated, and takes it off the glass. Never did that ball drop even an inch. He kept it high and shot it high.
Most of the time when the ball drops, Mark, it ends up going the other way. Illinois State, Brown off balance and perfect.
Good
little fade to that move.
Good news for Redbird fans. Tyler Brown brought his A offensive game today.
Stutz and a reach. A foul called by John Higgins. Closed captioning for today's telecast is made possible by Emerson, the global technology engineering company. To learn more, visit Emerson.com. Emerson, consider it solved. Jackie Carmichael reached in and committed his first foul. Each team with a foul now. Ragland 1, Carmichael 1. And Ragland will inbound at the baseline for Wichita State. Here's Smith. Eakey taps the ball over to his teammate, John Wilkins. Wilkins, a 6'9 junior from France in the lineup for Illinois State, along with Bryant Allen, number two.
Keep your eye on number one, Tyler Brown, and number two, Bryant Allen. Two critical elements to the offense today for Illinois State, right on cue, Tyler Brown.
There you go. 7 points for Brown right out of the gate. 9-7, Illinois State. And the ball's going to go the other way. Stutz with the personal foul sends us to a break. Illinois State leads by two as we play the semifinals of the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament. Illinois State has come out strong today against the top seed Wichita State, a 2-point lead for the Redbirds here in the first half. Our Missouri Valley Conference standings are a presentation of Purina Dog Chow. Long live your dog. Wichita State is after its 28th victory. Illinois State, its 20th win of the season. And later on today, we'll see Creighton, a 26-game winner, up against Evansville, looking for win number 17. And Stutz committed a foul just before the break. And we've seen Stutz get in foul trouble like Creighton on the road at Omaha. And it seemed like the Shockers were able to elevate their game. But how about the importance of that early foul inside?
Critical as you watch Garrett Stutz to stay out of foul trouble today, along with Jackie Carmichael at Illinois State. Whoever gets in foul trouble in that situation, advantage to the opponent.
With some full court pressure, Illinois State will bring it up as the Shockers back away. David Kyles, number 24, is in the game, and he's watching Nick Moore.
Well, I'd be awfully tempted to go right at Stutz. There they are, one-on-one, matched up down low.
Wilkins with the fadeaway that wouldn't go over Stutz.
Why fade? You got to attack there at Stutz to go get him in foul trouble.
And Stutz attacks Wilkins, and it's poked away and stolen by Brown. Brown on the drive, and he scores it. He has 9 points after scoring 8 points February 22nd against Wichita State.
We said that Tyler Brown has to score along with Bryant Allen. Tyler Brown is keeping up his end of the deal. Remember, one in red for Illinois State.
Off the bench, Carl Hall will check in a moment for Wichita State. Stutz going to the glass, and the volley, Stutz wins it. Wichita State hangs on to the possession. Ray Murray in the lane, soft touch on the one-hander.
Wilkins and Stutz on the floor, a little bit of activity there. Wilkins is trying to get Stutz into a physical battle and draw fouls. That's his job today.
Time has been called here by John Higgins.
This will be reviewed to see if there's any type of unsportsman activity or, there goes a forearm right to Stutz's face. This will be reviewed. Take a look now. They both go down right there. And remember, the memo went out this week to all officials to enforce sportsmanship in college basketball. It is a true point of emphasis. Take a look at the right-hand side. In a battle, they both go down. And right there, it is. The left forearm hits Stutz. And that could end up being a flagrant one or even a flagrant two foul because of the elbow rule. And the officials are reviewing it right now.
And Stutz got caught with the forearm or the back of the hand right on the bridge of the nose.
This is what the officials are reviewing. First of all, the elbow rule, does the elbow come above the shoulders? Now at this point, no, they both go down together. But as they're flailing around, right there, that's what's going to be reviewed. Was it a basketball play? The answer to that is definitely no. Was it excessive? If it's deemed to be excessive, then we start getting into a flagrant one foul or a flagrant two foul, depending on intent.
As Wilkins had his left foot caught between Garrett Stutz's legs, tried to work free, and then here it comes.
And there's definitely contact above the shoulders.
around the officials talk about it, John Higgins, Kelly Self, and Don Daly worked this Wichita State-Illinois State game, and they're over at the scorer's table near the monitor now.
My personal opinion, after watching the review like the officials, I think that's a flagrant two foul, because it looked to me like there was intent to retaliate there. And the official will come over now, and we'll visit with him to find out exactly what the call is.
And while Mark does that, the other two officials are talking with the head coaches, Greg Marshall and Tim Jankovic, at midcourt, as you see that on your monitor. And we're getting the explanation right now, and Mark is going to pass that along. What's the word, Mark?
Because the ball was dead at that point, they deemed that it was dead, and so it's a contact technical foul to the contact above the shoulders. If the ball would have been deemed live, it would have been a flagrant two foul. Either way, this will mean free throws for Wichita State plus possession.
Torrey Murray has 4 points. He scored on this play, and the ball was dead when the foul occurred, and Murray will be shooting from the free throw line while the other players stand at midcourt and look on.
John, remember, when we opened this game, we talked about who's going to get into foul trouble. Will it be Jackie Carmichael or Garrett Stutz? And you can see how physical this game has become. And you've got to think that John Wilkins came in the game not to be dirty. That's not the point. But to go after Garrett Stutz and try to get him and lure him into a physical type situation. So with the contact, dead ball, technical foul, now it's possession, Wichita State.
Wichita State scoring 4, looking for 6 out of this exchange. We have a tie game, Wichita State, Illinois State. Smith piles at the point. Williams looking in on Moore. Smith looking inside. He finds Carl Hall. Smith, a long three. Carmichael getting inside Hall. And Carmichael is picking up where he left off yesterday. The Redbirds eliminated Northern Iowa 54-42. Carmichael had 15 boards, 5 off his career high.
And now Wichita State counters with Hall, number 22 in white. He will be physical with Jackie Carmichael in the paint.
Hall's quite an athlete. Here's Johnny Key. He keeps bumping in, and a foul call. That's on Dimitri Williams, his first. Team foul number 3. Illinois State from the baseline. Carmichael will hand off to his point guard, the freshman from Winona Lake, Indiana, Nick Moore. Smith and short, and there's Torrey Murray. Murray averages around 5 rebounds a game. He's handling the basketball now, bumping into Eke. Getting inside, Eke for the layup.
Torrey Murray just used a little push dribble out front to split the defenders. You rarely see that successful in traffic, but he's a good enough athlete to get away with it.
Well, the quickness, that was a key to victory on the basket, the last basket by Murray. And a good save by Bryant Allen. Wichita State is on a 6-0 run. Here is Moore, and he was blocked off by David Kiles.
Man, what a recovery.
A 3 attempt. And there's David Kiles with the missed 3. And Kiles will bring it in, set it up for Wichita State. Entry pass, Smith over the hoop, and a foul on Hall, who pushed off on Jackie Carmichael. And the foul on Hall is his first. And with the dead ball, Anthony Cousin, number 5, checks in for Illinois State. And Jake White, number 50, a 6'8 freshman, from Chaska, Minnesota, who's in for the Shockers. And here's Zeke Upshaw, 24, in the red jersey for Illinois State.
You can sense there's so much on the line for these two teams. The only route to the NCAA tournament is for Illinois State to knock off the number 14 team in the country, Wichita State, right now playing for a higher and better seed in the NCAA tournament. Right now I project them as a number 4 seed, but it's not inconceivable they could move to a number 3 seed with a victory today and ultimately winning the championship tomorrow.
Carmichael out of the double team, stepping up. The scoop shot, it won't count. Tyler Brown is called for the foul, and Wichita State will have the ball when we come back.
Torrey Murray showing leadership for the Wichita Shockers as he catches, attacks, pushes it right there, explodes the hoop. Torrey Murray off the glass.
They have Arch Bailey. Time now for today's Murray Farms NBC Scholar Athlete of the Game. Illinois State's John Ikey, the sophomore forward from Independence, Missouri, has a 3.27 GPA in business administration, shoots 40% three-point range. The farmer-owned Prairie Farm family dairies, Prairie Farms, Highland and Roberts dairies, farm fresh quality from our family to yours, John.
Scott, a 6-0 run for Wichita State over the last 2 minutes and 48 seconds. That put the Shockers ahead by 2, 13-11, and a chance to add to the lead after the timeout. But a physical game, an upbeat game right from the very beginning here in the Missouri Valley semifinals. Terrific entry pass. White is blocked off inside, and it's a held ball. Zeke Upshaw, some good work defensively for Illinois State. Illinois State with the basketball. The inbound, number 1, Tyler Brown, a junior from Owensboro, Kentucky. Member of the All-MVC newcomer team.
Wichita State knows they have better depth than Illinois State. That's why they're going with their little token full court man-to-man pressure to try to wear down the guards of Illinois State.
Carmichael with the high grab, working against Hall. Short on the shot, and there's Joe Ragland.
Good defense by Carl Hall inside on Carmichael.
24 is David Kyle. Carmichael on the switch. Brown is with him. White with the rebound and the putback. Jake White. He'll go to the free throw line. As Jackie Carmichael committed his second foul, White gets the basket and a free throw out of this.
Just a junkyard dog. Getting after him. Really had a size advantage inside against Cousin and just used him down the paint.
An 8-0 run for Wichita State, and White has a chance to add to that with 10 minutes and 43 seconds left in the first half. Substitution for Illinois State, Ikey comes back in. Upshaw goes out.
It's interesting to watch Tim Jankovic manage minutes for Jackie Carmichael. Jackie Carmichael is such a critical element defensively, blocking shots, rebounding the basketball. You know, these games get to be just brutal physically.
Three-point play for Jake White. And Wichita State is open to 16-11 lead.
And how important is Jackie Carmichael? Double-double important. 12 double-doubles on the season. Derek Stutz with 11. Doug McDermott with 10. Mamadou Sek just behind there as well.
Number 2 is Brian Allen, shooting from the point. That rims out. A hustling rebound for Jake White, who has been a spark off the bench for Wichita State. Murray was open and blocked off by Wilkins. Wilkins with some good help as Brian Allen had to try to work coming from behind, and now he's on the floor as he absorbs some contact. And there's plenty of that in the first half, Mark.
Let's identify number 2. He's right there out on the wing. And Torrey Murray came back with his elbow and hit Brian Allen in the face. Of course, it was unintentional. That doesn't matter a whole lot to Brian Allen at this point. Watch Torre Murray.
No, it doesn't.
Right there. Oh, man, he got him big time.
And Allen is still getting attention from the training staff for Illinois State. Torre Murray is off to a terrific start today with 8 points. He had 9 in the February 22nd game against Illinois State.
Tim Jankovic was just asking the officials, is that reviewable? The officials came in and said, no, it was an inadvertent situation, no call. So it doesn't look like this, and I don't think it should be reviewable. They saw it in live action. Apparently, it doesn't appear it will be reviewed. And Tim Jankovic is fine with that explanation.
As he looks on, his player Brian Allen down after taking a hit from Torre Murray.
Well, and this, of course, is a guy that has a great football background as well. So he can take a hit. The training staff doing a good job checking him out. You know, as a coach, John, I've been in this situation several times, and naturally your first concern is for the health of your player. And there's those relationships that you have. You trust your training staff. They're asking him a series of questions right now to determine if he possibly had a concussion or not, if he's ready to get up.
Well, this is a physical start to our semifinal action in the Missouri Valley. Take a look.
There's the screen on Torre Murray. It's been physical all afternoon long. Stepping in and taking the charge. Down in the low block, Eric Stutz gets called for a push. And then Wilkins retaliates right there for the dead ball technical. The ball is flying around. Bodies are flying around.
Now back to live action in St. Louis. Wichita State with the ball. Joe Ragland backing it away, and the Shockers set up their offense. In the corner, David Kiles. Here's Stutz. Rebound inside, and White scores it. Jake White has 5. A chance to get 6.
Watch Jake White work the backside. Look, he's already getting positioned early, and he stays so low and sits down. And again, Cousin on the backside. Watch. He's already established his position before the shot ever goes up. That's great anticipation by that young man.
Anthony
Jake
Cousin
White.
Put White on the line, and he missed on this three-point opportunity.
The early preparation for the offensive board work, very impressive by Jake White.
Here's Wilkins. Brown. That funnels out. Stutz on the rebound for Wichita State.
Garrett Stutz, such a better rebounder than he was a year ago. He only averaged 3.5 rebounds a year ago. It's a 1-2 thing.
A three ball. And timeout ball by Illinois State. Ragland with the assist, and Kyle's first field goal goes for 3 Wichita State points. A 10-point lead for the Shockers.
David Kiles loves the three ball. 3 out of every 4 shot attempts for number 24, David Kiles, comes from behind the arc, and that one was behind the NBA arc. Look how deep he is. Feet are set, let it fly. That's called range.
A 12-0 run since the technical foul for Wichita State.
It's almost as if Illinois State got Wichita State's attention with that technical foul.
Let's get an update from our courtside reporter, Tom Ackerman.
Brian Allen has been taken into the tunnel towards the Illinois State locker room. We'll get an update on him momentarily, but he has been taken off the floor. And as you mentioned, tough kid, football player, and from St. Louis, Maplewood Richmond Heights, about 10-minute drive from Scott Trade Center.
Illinois State with the ball. Last made field goal, 14:54 on the first half clock for the Redbirds. And a miss by Anthony Cousin. There's Stutz. right. Smith off the glass. And a rebound for John Wilkins of Illinois State. Contact. And a foul as Anthony Cousin was kind of trying to create something for Illinois State. And the fouls on David Kiles, his first. Five team fouls each way with 8:30 to go in the first half.
Be interesting to see how long Jack Carmichael sits with this lead currently at 10 for Wichita State.
Carmichael left a while ago with two personal fouls.
And that's the conundrum. As Greg Marshall looks on, he knows that Illinois State becomes virtually defenseless inside without Jackie Carmichael. So what will Wichita State do? Pound it inside the studs. Get it in the paint.
Your Cousin goes 1-for-2 from the free throw line. 21-12, Wichita State. Dimitri Williams. There's Kyle's quick release. And too strong that time. A foul. Stutz goes over John Wilkins' back. And let's check in with Tom Ackerman, courtside.
John, the update on Bryant Allen. He's been taken in for concussion tests. So if he's able to pass those, he'll be able to return to action. But for right now, he is off the floor. He is in the Illinois State training room receiving concussion tests.
Carl Hall in and Stutz out for Wichita State. Some mild full-court pressure applied by the Shockers. And down to 8 minutes to go in the first half.
Well, the good news is that Bryant Allen did walk off the floor on his own.
Boy, Cousin is left, then his right. Ickey from the corner. And a line drive rebound for Williams. Murray, the quick step into the lane. But he is blocked off by Cousin. Williams around to Smith, back to the point.
It's good ball movement. They isolate Hall down low.
Hall with some pumping. Out for Kyles, a three ball. As that went off Ray Murray's head, here's Cousin for Illinois State in the front court.
Is this football, soccer, or basketball?
A little bit of all of the above. And we have a foul called against Wichita State. That's against Williams, his second. 1-1 coming up for the Redbirds when we return to St. Louis and Arch Madness presents bench. You see Bryant Allen for Illinois State. He's still getting attention from the trainer. In the meantime, Jackie Carmichael left with his second foul. 10:43 to go in the half. Since then, Wichita State has outscored the Redbirds 6-1. Leading 21-12.
Well, the good news for Bryant Allen, obviously he's carrying on a conversation with the training staff there. They've been working on his nose. He's been spitting out some blood here and there. But they're working on him, and he appears to be at least consciously all here, which is a very good sign.
Nick Moore shooting the 1-1 earns a bonus. Nick had 23 points against Wichita State. That was back in January.
The basketball side of the equation, without Bryant Allen, he's a very dynamic scorer. This is a guy that can go for 30 points in a game. He went for 29 against Creighton earlier this year, so he's one of those dynamic scorers that's not available right now to Tim Jankovic.
Joe Ragland attempting a three, and he is successful for the second time today. The last field goal for the Redbirds, you see it, 14:54 in the first half. Along the baseline, Hall blocks John Wilkins. And for Hall, his second foul.
Watch Carl Hall, number 22. And he definitely fouls him. There's no question about that. But that was a pretty impressive quick jump. An attack of the basketball.
Wilkins shoots 79% from the line. One more coming and in play at 6:50 to go in the first half.
The thing I like about Carl Hall, he doesn't do anything halfway. He's committed.
He plays with a lot of enthusiasm, Mark. Skill, ability, and strength. This is a tough, deep Wichita State team.
You know, they can play boa constrictor type of defense. They can absolutely just squeeze you to death with their athleticism, with their quickness, with their determination. they can be devastating on defense.
Oruke, number 21. There's another example of the depth of this Wichita State team. A terrific shot blocker with 29. He's in the game setting the pick. And here's Murray. So smooth. Torrey Murray in double figures with 10 first half points.
Ahime Arupe is like a goalie in soccer. He's in there to block shots and intimidate in the paint. Number 21 in white.
Here's Brown, and Wilkins couldn't get close to the pass. With the Redbird turnover, Wichita State will take it the other way. And off the bench, Johnny Hill. Hill did not play against UNI yesterday. He's a 6'3 freshman from Glendale Heights, Illinois. On the turnovers so far, Illinois State just committed its fourth. Wichita State has turned the ball over five times.
Well, Johnny Hill having to play because Bryant Allen sitting on the bench after that elbow to his chin.
And Jordan Treloff is not here in St. Louis. The backup center out with a broken thumb.
That's why fouls so critical, especially for Illinois State. They're just light inside.
Here's Kyles. And Arupke is sealed off nicely. Hickey was able to get to the loose basketball. Wilkins in on Arupke. And a foul is called as David Kyles was going for the rebound. And he's fouled by Johnny Hill, his first.
I like the way
number six.
I like the way Ahime Arupe has come into this basketball game. He's been able to intimidate. We saw a turnover on the previous possession for Tim Jankovic's team. It's because of his length and the missed shot on the last one, because of his ability to challenge shots. Very, very long, number 21 in white.
Ragland working against a freshman, Moore. And a push is called as Hill lost a step to David Kyles. Two quick fouls on Johnny Hill. Kyles is putting on a clinic, the senior, against the Illinois State freshman. And Allen is back in the game. Bryant Allen. And he's ready to get back into the flow of things here for Illinois State. In the meantime, David Kyles on the free throw line. Both teams are in the bonus. That was the seventh team foul for Illinois State. Both are in the 1-1.
Really pleased to see Bryant Allen back in the basketball game. Tough, tough kid.
Kyles, a senior from Dallas. One more coming his way as he looks for his fifth point. 14 minutes yesterday against Indiana State, and he scored five with a couple of rebounds and one assist.
You know, Greg Marshall has that luxury of rotating big guy after big guy into the game, and with Jackie Carmichael with two fouls, and now down by 12. And Tim Jankovic is not going to roll the dice. Doesn't appear, and bring Jackie Carmichael back into this basketball game before the half. Maybe forced to.
Wilkins, Brown around to Moore. Coming down to 5 minutes left in the first half.
Watch how the white jerseys react to the dribble on defense. Everybody's in help side position. Everybody's bluffing and recovering toward the ball.
Smith is able to take the ball before Tyler Brown could get there for Illinois State.
It's interesting how they move in concert together. On-ball defense with off-ball defense, Wichita State.
Short off the glass. Missed by Torrey Murray. 14:54, a layup by Brown was the last field goal for Illinois State, and Murray near steal. Contact, Arupke is called for the foul on McMoore. Ahime Arupke with his first personal foul and the ninth foul on the Shockers in the half. Let's check in with Tom Ackerman courtside here.
Well, the official statement on Bryant Allen is that it was a precautionary concussion test, and he did pass that test, so he is back in there. This is something they'll do normally with players in that situation. They'll take a look at the player before the injury, after the injury, and make sure that everything is good to go. So Bryant Allen, who played football, has been hit a time or two. He was a wide receiver at Minnesota, transferred to Illinois State. You know, Tim Jankovic enjoyed recruiting him, recruited him hard, but he went to Minnesota, then decided to transfer to Illinois State. You ask any player on this team who brings energy to the Redbirds, it's Brian Allen. And as you mentioned, he can score in bunches. I did that game against Prady at 29 points. He was hitting step-back threes. It was an unbelievable performance.
The ball's going to go the other way to Wichita State. Kyles was complaining he was fouled by Wilkins on the other end. No call at all. But now Wichita State gets the ball back with 4:05 left in the half and a healthy 28-18 lead here in the Missouri Valley Conference semifinals.
Well, David Kyles knocked down that early three, and he's been settling for fool's gold since that time.
Murray traveled, lost his balance as he entered the lane. And we have 3:57 left in the first half. Wichita State, the number 14 team in the country, has the lead over Illinois State. The top seed, number 14 in the nation, Wichita State, 28-18 over Illinois State in the Missouri Valley Conference semifinals. The Larry Bird Trophy is given annually to the Missouri Valley Conference's outstanding men's basketball player. Emerson is excited to be the proud presenting partner of this year's award. Visit NBCSports.com to learn more. Emerson Song, and congratulations to Doug McDermott from Creighton, who will play in our second game today against Evansville. As McDermott is this year's recipient of the Larry Bird Trophy.
I believe he's a first-team All-American and should get serious consideration for National Player of the Year. That kid has had a tremendous year as a sophomore.
Since the Illinois State technical foul, the Shockers are on a 17-7 run. They opened up the 10-point game. And Carmichael has been out with two fouls. Here's Wilkins in on a rip game. Won't go. Arukye's second foul since coming off the bench. He's from Lagos, Nigeria, and attended Three Rivers, Missouri Junior College before going to Wichita State. Wichita State off the bench has outscored Illinois State 10-1. Cousin has the 1 point off the bench for Illinois State. Wilkins. For three from the line today.
Well, he's a critical element to this Illinois State situation with the foul situation with Jackie Carmichael, the injury situation with this basketball team overall.
Number 50, Jake White is back in for Wichita State as Wilkins drops in his fourth consecutive free throw today. Now an 8-point lead for Wichita State as Illinois State's looking for a defensive stand here.
Smaller but very athletic lineup for Wichita State.
Ben Smith drawing contact. And that foul is called against Darius Clark. That's the 9th foul for Illinois State.
Boy, Greg Marshall sure has a lot of buttons he can push. Ben Smith at 6'5", on the floor right now. Joe Ragland at the point guard position. Cotton at 6'2". Torrey Murray at 6'5".
And this is an NIT championship team that lost 4 contributing seniors last year.
You know, but the thing that Greg White does a great job of is developing depth over the course of time. You know, he's not afraid to go to his bench and get everybody involved. I think that's been a real key to his success. But you can only do that if you recruit at the highest level. Wichita State doesn't settle for a lot of players that some mid-majors do. They shoot very, very high, and they'll miss on guys. But every once in a while, they steal a guy.
All 9 of Illinois State's points since the technical foul have come from the free throw line, going 9 out of 10. And there's another miss on a field goal attempt, that time by Brian Allen. To Cale Cotton. Giving it up to Joe Ragland. Ragland, a member of the All-NBC Improved Team. Three ball for him. His third today. He is so good. Timeout, Illinois State. 2:55 left in the first half as Wichita State has opened a 13-point lead.
Look at him surveying the defense, and Nick Moore, the freshman, backs off of Joe Ragland. And Joe Ragland says, if you're not going to respect my jump shot, I'm going to shoot it right in your face, Nick Moore. And that's exactly what he does right there.
The first lead of the day for Wichita State. And from the three-point arc, Wichita State is 4 for 11. Illinois State 1 for 6, and that belongs to Brown. Raglan is 3 for 3.
Raglan changed his career on one missed shot at Missouri State last season. For the conference championship, the Missouri State won it. Late-game situation, and Joe Raglan took an ill-advised three-point shot. And then all of a sudden, the students flooded the floor at Missouri State. If you saw the reaction of Joe Raglan and his teammates on that Saturday afternoon, almost 1 year ago, that young man decided, this will never happen to me and to my team again. And now he's led this team to number 14 in the country and a regular season championship in the Missouri Valley Conference.
Here's Moore. And that goes for three. Nick Moore's first field goal is a three-pointer. He has 7.
Little message from the freshman point guard.
First field goal in over 12 minutes for Illinois State. And that freshman, Moore, had 23 against Wichita State in January. Raglan, counted by John Ikey. Torrey Murray at the three-point line, 12 seconds on the shot clock. The tip by Murray won't go, and there's John Wilkins. Brown going through a double team and a reach in called on Torrey Murray. Murray's first foul. Wichita State's over the 10 foul limit in the first half. Two shots coming up here for Illinois State, and Illinois State has been able to hang in, going 9 for 10 from the free throw line. It's a 10-point game, but the Redbirds are making points when the clock is stopped.
Now, we've heard a lot from Tyler Brown early in this basketball game, not so much lately.
He went 4 for 7 right out of the gate and got 9 points, and then took only one field goal attempt. One more here for Brown. He makes them both. 11 for Brown.
Well, and there's the guy, Jackie Carmichael. This team now down 8 with Carmichael with 2 fouls, and he has sat for a long time here in the first half.
Kyles with the one hand short. White's there to clean it up.
I love that kid. All he does is come off the bench and contribute. He does the little things. He makes a coach smart.
He did not score. He had 1 rebound in 8 minutes against Indiana State in yesterday's quarterfinal game. 7 points so far today. Here's Brown stopping, popping, count it. Brown has 13. 35-27, Shockers. We come down to 1 minute left in the half, and the entry pass is deflected.
Big possession right here. Look for Tyler Brown. He's the hot hand.
Hickey. Short.
Bad shot.
Out of bounds to Wichita State. And shrugging his shoulders over on the sideline, Tim Jankovich, and now clapping his hands, trying to encourage his team to get the ball back.
Jake White again getting early offensive rebound position. Someone taught him how to do that at a really early age, and he has perfected it.
Inside, Smith.
He does it again.
White. With the follow, it won't go this time. But there's Smith, and he's fouled. Second chance points today. Wichita State is 9 better than the Redbirds, 11-2.
Look at Jake White. Look at him on the left hip. He creates space for himself by doing that. A little bit off balance right there. But that's why that kid is so effective. It's the preparation to go retrieve the basketball.
And John Ikey put Ben Smith on the free throw line. Perfect.
When the ball's in flight, officials and everybody else tend to watch ball flight, and you get away with those little subtle nudges inside. He does it extremely well.
9 offensive rebounds for Wichita State in the first half. And there's a miss for Smith. That's his first in 4 opportunities. 36-27, Shockers. Tyler Brown with 13 first half points. Wilkins with the pick. Bryant Allen. John Wilkins working on White. That's going up. shots here for John Wilkins, junior from France. 15 minutes against Northern Iowa yesterday with 6 points, 4 rebounds, 1 block shot. Getting extended playing time here, and he's needed for some size on the baseline with Jackie Carmichael on the bench, sitting most of the first half with 2 fouls.
Last night, late first half, Illinois State on defense, Tim Jankovic showed 2-3 zone, and in mid-possession, then went man-to-man. He's calling out defensive signals right now to his team. He often decoys an offense by switching in mid-possession, late-game situations. They're showing man-to-man here. It looks they'll stay man.
Just another note, Mark, about Carmichael. He's played only 8 minutes in the first half.
They show man and go 2-3 zone, exact opposite of what Tim Jankovic did last night. Illinois State in the 2-3 zone.
Here's Kyles. And that misses as the horn sounds. Wichita State with a healthy first half and a lead of 36-28 over Illinois State. And now it's time to check in with Tom Ackerman for tonight's St. Charles Convention and Visitors Bureau plans for the second half, Tom.
Thank you, John. We're here with Greg Marshall. Hi, Coach. Thanks for being with us. The first 20 minutes and now 20 more. How do you get to the final on Sunday?
Stop fouling. You know, they're living on the foul line. We got to stop fouling. Had 4 guys over here in foul trouble.
Good luck in the second half. Thank you.
Our convention tournament, 36-28, Wichita State. Between 14:54 on the first half clock and 2 minutes 41 seconds to go, Illinois State did not hit a field goal. But they stayed in the game by hitting free throws 9 out of 10. Let's go over to Tom Ackerman as it's time to check in for our St. Charles Convention and Visitors Bureau plans for the second half.
Thank you, John. Coach, your thoughts on what has been a physical basketball game so far?
Very physical. Much like yesterday, we feel a little fortunate to be in the game. You know, we don't have our backup center. Jackie got 2 fouls, and we need one of those 2 guys, and we don't have them. So I felt pretty good that we could, you know, stay within striking distance. We'll have to play better, obviously, the second half. But it could have gotten away from us a little bit. I thought our guys just battled their tail off. And I thought they hit some really tough shots, too. So second half will be interesting.
Good luck. Thank you.
Our chat with Tim Jankovic, head coach at Illinois State, is brought to you by St. Charles, Missouri Convention and Visitors Bureau. When making plans to attend the 2012 State Farm MVC Women's Basketball Championship, go to www.historicstcharles.com or call 800-366-2427. Mark Adams alongside. I'm John Rooney. Mark, it was a physical, tough first half, and now with Jackie Carmichael coming back into the game in the second half, it could be a little different story for Illinois State against a very difficult Wichita State team.
Well, Tim Jankovic really rolled the dice in the first half as Jackie Carmichael only played for 8 minutes, sat for 12 in the first half. Remember our pregame keys for Wichita State? It was to shock Jackie. Jackie only had 2 points in the first half and be merciless on the glass. And Wichita State plus 8, but still an 8-point game, very much within reach. So Tim Jankovic gambles, and he wins in the first half, stays in it.
And check out the numbers. Carmichael, 2 points, 2 fouls, the same for Garrett Stutz.
So we talked about a battle of attrition in the paint. Both coaches went in with the game plan to get the other big into foul trouble. Both did that actually successfully. It's so critical, though, for Illinois State to keep Jackie Carmichael on the floor. Remember Greg Marshall at the halftime interview said, stop fouling. We just got to stop fouling. Well, bottom line is, he can manage the foul situation through his depth much more effectively than Tim Jankovic can, because Tim Jankovic doesn't have the same level of depth of Wichita State.
As we await the teams returning to the court here for the second half, offensive rebounds. Talk about how physical the game was. Wichita State out-rebounded Illinois State 9-2. Second chance points, 12-2 for Wichita State over the Redbirds. And then in the lane, the points in the paint favored Wichita State by 10, 14-4. And it is 36-28. Wichita State as we open play in the second half. Stutz and Carmichael each played 8 minutes in the first half. 2 points, 2 fouls. They'll start out the second half. Stutz number 41 in white, Carmichael number 32 in red. And the ball belongs to Wichita State. Here we go. Joe Ragland had 3 3-point field goals in the first half.
Look for inside touch for Stutz. Number 41 in white. That's their goal to open the half. Get it inside, either off the dribble or the big guy off the pass.
Murray shoots for two.
Good defense by Illinois State.
And a foul call.
Wow.
On Jackie Carmichael right out of the gate here in the second half. His third personal.
And Tim Jankovic just rubs his forehead.
The Wichita State fans applaud the announcement of Carmichael's third foul. Stutz taking the inbounds pass, Ragland, and he was denied initially by Wilkins, but there's the follow, Tim. Stutz has four.
And Jackie Carmichael becomes virtually defenseless with that third foul here early in the second half. And nearly an illegal screen.
Nick Moore, Carmichael, working against Stutz. One bounce, and then out to Brown. Nice position inside for Ben Smith.
I'd go right at Carmichael. I'd find a way to get it inside and attack him. There it is.
But off Stutz's hand. Here's Moore all the way in, and blocked by Ben Smith. And a miss by Wilkins for Teray Murray. Smith, in there. His first field goal is a three-point basket. He averages 9-7 a game, 6 today. 41-28. Wichita State on defense with the lead.
Well, you almost sense from Jackie Carmichael that he's reluctant to bring energy right now because of his foul situation. We've seen a guy play possessed in Jackie Carmichael, and now guys like Brian Allen are going to have to pick up that intensity and score from the perimeter.
Brian Allen got a good look and knocked it down for his first field goal. Here's Smith. He hit one a moment ago but missed that three-point attempt. Allen in on Ragland, stops, pops, and Ragland committed his second foul. That puts Brian Allen on the free throw line for two. And with the first free throws of the half, the veterans of Four Moores Foundation and the Missouri Valley Conference ask you to participate in the Return the Favor Charity Stripe campaign. This season, the VFW Foundation and the Valley encourage fans to return the favor to those who protect our country. You can be a part of helping our troops by texting RETURN to 90999. Or log on to mvcsports.com/charitystripe to make a pledge or a gift to help our military and their families.
Well, thanks to all those veterans, and what an emotional star-spangled banner this afternoon. The singer was in his Navy uniform, and we honored several veterans here today. This conference absolutely does it right. What a first-class operation, first-class people, with the leadership of Doug Elgin, Jack Watkins, Mike Kern, just a tremendous job here in St. Louis running this tournament.
Here is Stutz missing the dunk, but saved by Ben Smith. Smith from behind the arc. Followed his shot, and Jackie Carmichael deflected the ball away from him. Now running the floor, the scoop is good for Brown. Give him 15 today. And on the line, said Dimitri Williams, turns it over. Careless on the inbounds pass.
Actually, it was the Illinois State defender who decided to double back on Joe Ragland. Dimitri Williams assumed he could pass the ball inbounds, but all of a sudden you end up denying. See Nick Moore right there? Mm-hmm. He just a little bit of a defensive decoy, and it allowed Dimitri Williams just to make the turnover.
9 shocker turnovers today. Bounce pass low and a foul. Or was it? No, it just got away. Just bounced off the shot clock. I got blocked out on that one. I thought I saw an official point to a player. So it goes the other way. Protecting the ball, Smith.
Well, they clear it out.
Teray misses that time. Murray scored 10 in the first half. Here's Brown for three.
Brown's halfway down.
Rattles out to Williams. Allen right there with Raglan. Shots guarded by Carmichael. Quick pass. Stutz over Carmichael. Six for Garrett Stutz.
Carmichael can't guard. He's got three fouls on him, and he's not going to foul out. But frankly, he's not bringing anything else to his team right now. These guys played with energy throughout this latter part of the season. He's playing very tentative right now.
Allen falls as he missed the shot. Carmichael finds Nick Moore. Illinois State's 2-for-7 from the field this half. 3-for-8.
Boy, Nick Moore very much in attack mode. Went right at the 7-footer, Garrett Stutz.
Moore has 9 points. Stutz in on Carmichael. Carmichael makes some contact.
He sure did. He rolled him right out of bounds. He got away with one there.
Brown with the ball fake. Here's Wilkins. In there. Eight for John Wilkins.
The number 14 team in the country is being challenged by Illinois State right now.
And under some adverse conditions with Carmichael playing with three fouls. Raglan takes charge. He has 11.
How many big shots does that kid make in critical times for Wichita State? I'll tell you how many. Darn near every big possession.
11 for Joe Raglan. And a 6-point lead for the Shockers. Here's Brown. He can't.
Boy, he's feeling it.
18 for Brown. That's his second three ball today. A 3-point game. Wichita State had a 13-point lead at 3:01 to go in the first half. That has been whittled down to just one possession. And the ball's going back to Illinois State. The Redbirds are on the run. 18 for Tyler Brown. Nick Moore scores there. He has 9. And it's a 3-point game in St. Louis, Missouri. March Madness continues after this. Convenience store and a whole lot more. One more game after this one. Evansville against number 24 Creighton. Creighton is the number 2 seed in the conference. They split the regular season matchup, and Cole Ryan had 43 points at Creighton on the 21st of February. Boy, we've been entertained by this game, Mark. Mark Adams alongside, and in the second half, Illinois State 14-9 on an 8-2 run. 7 points off turnovers.
The leading scorer for the game, Tyler Brown, with 18, now takes a blow.
5 of those points off turnovers have come this half, and here's Wilkins. Good position inside for Ben Smith. Joe Raglan, the senior from Massachusetts. Torrey Murray. Smith looks in on John Ikey. And here's Raglan. Foul is called. As Raglan is going right after Bryant Allen. First foul on Allen. Team fouls, 2-2, Wichita State and Illinois State in the second half.
You know, I look at this Wichita State team and evaluate, why do they win? There's a lot of reasons for it. The bottom line is the great teams have to have an internal leader. And Joe Raglan is without question the internal leader of this basketball team. And it's been through some failure and some experimentation, but you don't want to experiment at this time of the season.
Well, Smith takes that away from Ike. He scores, and Ben Smith goes to the free throw line.
Over the last three games, Ben Smith has had as many offensive rebounds as defensive rebounds. Why? Because he pursues the ball. He's quick off his feet, and he understands how to establish position.
17 second chance points today for Wichita State, building a 49-42 lead. Smith has scored 9, 4 of those from the free throw line. Wilkins in on Hall, and Hall got him. The third on Carl. Team fouls are even at 3 in the second half.
Well, Tim Jankovic really knows his personnel. Carl Hall was matched up with John Wilkins, and Wilkins is a guy that's got good physical ability and quickness to go by you off the dribble, and Jankovic called for that specific set to get Wilkins one-on-one with Hall.
Cotton back in the game for Wichita State, along with Garrett Stutz, as Hall goes out. Demetric Williams also left. He's over on the bench alongside Coach Greg Marshall. Illinois State trailing by 7, coming down to 13 minutes left in the second half. Moore to an open John Eaton. Count it!
Nick Moore, the freshman, starting to take over the decision-making process on offense for Illinois State. Man, is he a smart freshman.
Eakey's first points of the game, a 3-ball.
Physical down low. Stutz is really beaten up with Wilkins down there. No call.
Cotton out to Smith. Smith funnels one in for 2. He has 11. Ben Smith did not score a field goal in the first half. Illinois State 3-for-5 from three-point range this half.
Watch number 11, Red. Watch how he manages the offensive possession. There's the clear out again for Wilkins.
Short for Allen. Wilkins volleys and keeps it alive for the Redbirds.
Tim Jankovic, every possession now is trying to isolate certain matchups. He likes this one.
Wilkins, and he's short with his shot. Ben Smith to Torrey Murray.
Boy, Stutz, very physical inside, trying to pin Wilkins.
Here's Cotton. And a foul.
Technical foul. I think we got a double technical foul on Wilkins
and Stutz.
On Stutz. Remember 2 possessions ago, we talked about how physical it was as Stutz sits down. Wrap around the arm by Wilkins, and they've been battling like this the entire time. A little bit of a subtle elbow right there, a push. There's the foul on Stutz, and then something was said. Stutz responds, and a double technical foul, it appears. This was 2 possessions ago. Watch this. There's physicality there. More bumping. Stutz trying to drive him out. Arm flows to the backside. This is where it started, ladies and gentlemen, and it ended up in a double technical foul.
The officials are sorting it out, talking it out right now, as John Higgins is over with Greg Marshall.
And remember the foul situation. Those could be tacked on.
Stutz picked up his 3rd personal foul. And a double technical on each player. So Wilkins gets his 2nd. So 4 fouls on Stutz. He picked Stutz. Stutz picked up the personal foul and the technical, and Wilkins gets the technical foul, his 2nd. We're going to a break. Take a deep breath. More to come from St. Louis with Wichita State leading Illinois 4 fouls. But Kelly Self gave us the explanation that it was the 2nd technical foul of the day for John Wilkins. He has been ejected from the game, and he leaves with 11:59 to go after 8 points and 8 rebounds, and really helping the Redbirds inside stay in this ball game, as Jackie Carmichael has been hampered by foul trouble from the first half to this point.
It's been very physical, and there's the foul by Stutz, and then the reaction, and then you get the double class A unsportsmanlike foul. And Wilkins now has been ejected from the game because that's his 2nd technical foul of this game.
The ball belongs to Illinois State, with Wichita State leading 51-45. Moore and Brown, Carmichael, Eakey, and Anthony Cousin on the floor for Illinois State. execution, Mark.
When the stakes are at their highest, your best players got to step up. And Nick Moore finds a wide open Jackie Carmichael off the pick and roll.
Jake White's second foul for Wichita State gives Carmichael a free throw. And he has 5 points. And that's after 16 points, 15 rebounds yesterday, 35 minutes against Northern Iowa.
So there's a lot of fight in these two dogs.
A lot left with 11:36 to play. Smith looking back door, White is covered. Kyles and the steal. All the way in for the layup. Tyler Brown has a 20-point day. And it's a one-point game. Illinois State has whittled away 12 of the 13 minutes to go in the first half. And John Ikey is called for his third foul. That's important to note with 11:09 to go in the game.
We've seen Tyler Brown doing it offensively. Here he does it defensively. We talk about the importance of Tyler Brown scoring today. He's keeping up his end of the bargain.
And on the line, it's Raglan in our State Farm Missouri Valley Tournament bracket to this point. Brayden and Evansville are coming up. Wichita State and Illinois State are hooked up in a fight. For auto, home, life, and banking, get to a better state, find an agent, or get a quote from statefarm.com.
Wichita State right now, in my view, a number four seed in the NCAA tournament. They're playing for an improved seed. With a victory here today and a potential win tomorrow, that seed could become of greater value to them. But Illinois State right now has the number 14 team in the country in quite a dogfight.
Moore will set up the offense. The freshman goes to work at the free throw line, lobbing low for Carmichael. He catches it and is stripped of the ball. And Smith was in there along with David Kyles, clogging up the middle. And Kyles around to Smith and then Torre Murray. Murray with the jumper. Oh, Bottoms. The first field goal in the second half.
Composure right there by Torre Murray. This is the most experienced team in the Missouri Valley, and they're showing it right now.
Brown shoots for three. Count it! 23 for Tyler Brown.
What a...
A two-point game. Wichita State with the lead on the ball.
Torre Murray really calling for the basketball. He feels it offensively. There he is.
Oh, and he had the step on Cousin. Blocked by Carmichael. Cousin with the ball. Moore from the three-point line. Ikey, he thought about it. Brown will take it. Over the backboard, back to Wichita State as the Shockers were able to hold on to a two-point lead. Substitution. Physical 22, Carl Hall back in along with Demetri Williams.
Jackie Carmichael with three fouls starting to turn up the energy now. Wow.
Wichita State with a two-point lead in the ball coming down to 9.5 minutes to go. There's Smith set up for the three, and it's too strong. Hall can't keep it alive along the sideline with Demetri Williams. The ball belongs to the team in red, the Illinois State Redbirds.
For the only avenue to the NCAA tournament for Tim Jankovic in Illinois State is to win this game and win tomorrow. You can feel the desperation of this basketball team.
Nick Moore finds an opening. There's Ikey for three, and it's short. But saved by Brown, and he's short with his shot. Slapped over to David Kyles. Kyles lost that one off his foot, out of bounds. An unforced turnover there, and the ball goes back to the Redbirds. We have 9:02 to play. Semifinal action. Arch Madness in St. Louis, sponsored by State Farm. Full court pressure for the Shockers on the Redbirds.
I like this look from Greg Marshall. Slow down a little pace right here. Be in attack mode.
shot clock.
And Wichita State settles into 2-3 zone for the first time today.
Here's Moore in there for three.
Nick Moore read the defense and knew exactly where the open spot was going to be along the baseline. That's a freshman thinking two passes ahead.
Illinois State has erased a 13-point deficit to take a one-point lead. And here's Ragland. Oh, how big is he? 16 for Joe Ragland. First team, All-Missouri Valley Conference. And the Shockers are back in front by two.
How many ways can you say leader, Joe Ragland?
With a clenched fist. Brown to Moore. Ragland has 17 points today. He's 4 for 4 from three-point range. Inside, Eakey can't score it. Carmichael does. And a timeout with 7:43 to go in the game. Illinois State wants to play some more this season.
Point guard versus point guard. Leadership.
But what great, great contenders for the award this year, including Ragland, who has 17 today, 4 for 4 from 3-point range.
Well, the big guy, Garrett Stutz, with 14 points and 8 rebounds. You know, when you look at Greg McDermott, here he is getting ready to go in the semifinals of Arch Madness, and he looks so relaxed. Why? He's got a son named Doug, who's really good. That's got to feel pretty good over there, you know what?
Real good. To learn more about the Larry Bird Trophy, visit NBCSports.com. Emerson, consider it done.
I got to improve my gene pool. I got to tell you that right now.
Carmichael has 8 points, 6 in the second half, and a one-point lead for the Redbirds, trying to upend the 14th-ranked team in the country.
Big possessions.
Seed in this tournament.
Big possessions throughout the season. Joe Ragland, number one in white. He's the guy that makes the play and makes the decision. Ball's in his hand.
Number five, Demetric Williams. Ben Smith put together an 11-point day. 8 on the shot clock.
High screen.
Eakey comes out on Ragland. Smith for three. Count it! His second 3-point field goal and 14 today for Smith.
From Joe Ragland.
A 2-point lead for the Shockers. Wichita State is 7 of 20 from 3-point range for the game. Carmichael in, drawing contact. And Jackie will be on the free throw line for two. The foul is on Arupke, his third personal.
Now Smith on defense, stretching out offense. The mid-range medium jump shot. And this is a great play on the offensive glass. He's so quick to the ball. And Ragland draws defenders and knows who to give it to. John, we are seeing over the last half dozen possessions as good a guard play at the point guard position as you're going to see. Nick Moore has been dynamic, and Joe Ragland has done exactly what he's done all season long. Lead this team to the number 14 ranking in the country and the Missouri Valley regular season championship.
Back to a standoff. 61 all. Murray working on Cousin. And Murray lays it in. Nice and easy does it.
Corey Murray, another one of those guys with a lot of experience, the senior.
Dipsy-Doo and Arupke with the block on Brown. Pass into Carmichael and he can't score. Wichita State's ball as Demetric Williams protects the basketball. Torrey Murray. He beat Cousin a moment ago. Back door, Ragland. Contact, no foul. Nick Moore the other way. Out of bounds. Last touch by the Shockers. Illinois State's basketball. We're down to that time, Mark, where every touch of the basketball is important. It's paramount.
The stakes are so high. Wichita State playing for an a great seed in the NCAA tournament. They've earned that with what they've done with their non-conference strength of schedule and their championship of the regular season in the Valley, the number eight great conference in the country.
Here's Moore. An open three for John Eakey. And the ball is poked out front to Tyler Brown.
Just watch Nick Moore, number 11 in red.
The start, stop all the way in and over the basket. And a foul against Illinois State as Demetric Williams was going for the loose basketball. That was a train wreck. Brown committed his second personal foul for Illinois State.
You know, neither team responds here. Neither player responds. They show maturity. Why? Because the officials kept control of this thing early with the multiple technical fouls.
I think another thing, Mark, that reviewing the plays on the monitor, it can cool situations instead of making the quick decision, okay, this is what we're going to do, and then get right back into play.
It's a good rule.
And it helps the officials get the play right. Wichita State, two-point lead. Terrain Murray, Carmichael is out on him. That's too long this time for Smith. Jackie Carmichael was able to go from outside, inside to get the defensive rebound.
Now if you're Illinois State, option A on the perimeter, number one, Tyler Brown. Inside is Jackie Carmichael, 32. There he is.
Carmichael in on a Arruke, and he scores it. Was losing his balance, but kept his eye on the rim, and it crawled through. 63 all, the Shockers and the Redbirds in St. Louis.
Now you got to defend Torrey Murray.
Timeout, Wichita State. 4:19 left on the second half.
Championship quarters. The VFW Foundation and the Missouri Valley Conference ask you to participate in the Return the Favor Charity Stripe campaign. Visit mvcsports.com/charitystripe to find out how you can return the favor to our military members and their families. Johnny?
Well, there's Greg Marshall, and he told you something before the ballgame, Mark.
We talked about the Missouri State experience when his team walked off the floor as a second-place finisher, and he asked his team, how does this feel? Then they came to St. Louis and lost to Indiana State in Arch Madness, and he asked his team, how does that feel? Then they went to the NIT and won it, and he reminded his team before this game, how does second place feel?
The shot clock reset when it should not have, so the officials are going to correct that.
Greg Marshall.
Shots. Carmichael makes his presence felt.
So we'll reset the shot clock at 13. Officials all over it.
They have the shot clock now at a 10. They have it at 10.
There you go. Reset it again.
4:04 left on the second half game clock. And Wichita State's Torrey Murray will inbound from the baseline to Garrett Stutz. Murray, high arc, and a little too long. The freshman, Nick Moore, is there for the bird.
And Nick Moore has done a masterful job of running this offense and getting touches for his best players out of control, Tyler Brown.
And there was Murray poking the ball free. Now in the front court for Wichita State, trying to break this tie.
With Stutz in the game, he's a big target.
Out of bounds to Illinois State. Ragland didn't quite get to the pass. We're going to another break. 3:33 to go. Here's our game reset made possible by Pepsi Max. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste. The arrow favors Wichita State. The team fouls. One more by the Redbirds. Both teams will be in the bonus. Each team has three timeouts. The Redbirds have the ball after the break with 3:33 to go. Since a double technical on Stutz and Wilkins at 11:59 in the second half, the Redbirds have outscored the Shockers by 6, 18-12.
Which was the opposite in the first half, the original technical. Illinois State really went to sleep for a while after that one.
And that was on Wilkins, so after the second technical, he was ejected.
a 17-5 run. From the point, Carmichael is too strong. Smith had the ball poked away by Allen. So Wichita State hangs on. Murray all the way in, and a foul. Tyler Brown tried to make up some ground. But it has been physical the entire day.
Well, if you turn the corner, you better be ready to take a bump, that's for sure.
And that bump was by Jackie Carmichael, his fourth. Deray Murray is 2-for-2 from the free throw line today.
You know, it's different, though, playing with three fouls with 18 minutes to go. And we saw Carmichael really kind of fade away a little bit from the game. But right now with a fourth foul with 2:51, you got to think you're going to die with your boots on. You might as well give it everything you got.
One more for Murray in play of 2:51 to go in the second half. Trying to give Wichita State a two-point lead. But Carmichael rebounds the miss.
Jackie Carmichael had 2 points in the first half.
8 minutes of play.
He's been assertive here in the second half, but he hasn't been on the bench.
Number two is Bryant Allen. And he had to alter his shot. He had no chance to score that. Wichita State with the lead, 1 point.
Well, the Illinois State defense just deflects the dribble so well.
Hall working on Carmichael. Gives up the dribble, 6 on the shot clock. The ball's in Ragland's hands. Hall lets it fly, and Illinois State gets it back.
Stingy, stingy defense by Illinois State.
Timeout taken by Tim Jankovic and the Illinois State Redbirds as we stay here in St. Louis.
Tim Jankovic has a lot of options right now. Nick Moore will be the trigger guy, and he will be looking for Tyler Brown, who's been the hot hand all afternoon long. And then you've got the added option of Jackie Carmichael inside. I would really try to deny this young man, Nick Moore, the basketball number 11. He gets it.
Moore is watched by Williams. Number two is Bryant Allen.
Good denial of Moore. They don't want him to retouch. He finally gets it back.
10 on the shot clock. Moore and Carmichael. 5 on the shot clock. Moore all the way in. And that funnels out. Hall has it. Hall out to Torrey Murray. Here's Williams. A 3. And Wichita State maintains the possession.
Torrey Murray just showed why he's so important to this basketball team, getting the offensive glass, just following shots.
Less than a minute to go in St. Louis, a 1-point lead for the top seed in the Missouri Valley Conference Tournament. And timeout, Wichita State.
I'm going to deny number one the basketball. I'm going to figure out a way that he just doesn't catch it, because when he does, he's so dangerous.
Ragland has 17 today. 15 for Murray, 14 for Ben Smith. Wichita State leads by 1. Ragland all the way in and a miss. Jackie Carmichael is there for the Redbirds.
But with that early shot, Wichita State assures themselves of another possession.
And that's poked out of bounds, and Torrey Murray is making the case that that should have been off Illinois State. And he's still pleading his case with John Higgins.
Hard to tell
with Higgins in the line on that shot.
11-second shot clock difference and game clock difference.
Timeout, Illinois State before the inbounds pass. And let's take a look at our State Farm Players of the Game, brought to you by State Farm, Toronto Home Life and Banking. Get to a better state, find an agent, or get a quote at statefarm.com. Tyler Brown, 3 points off his career high with 23 today. And Joe Ragland, when Wichita State has needed big points,
big lifts in the second half. He has provided them by going 5-for-8 from the field, 17 points, and Ragland is 4-for-4 from behind the arc.
For Illinois State now, down one, 23 seconds on the shot clock. Tim Jankovic is definitely going to want something in attack mode. Only down one where you can draw contact. Not saying don't take the three, but I think the three has to come from an aggressive inside-out play, either off the dribble or a pass into Jackie Carmichael in the paint.
Anything in sports, you can say this is a game of adjustments. But how about the adjustments Tim Jankovic and the Redbirds have had to make today because of early first-half foul trouble by Jackie Carmichael, then two technical fouls by John Wilkins, and that all happened after Jordan Treloff didn't make the trip to St. Louis because of a broken thumb. They've had things working against them coming to St. Louis, yet the Redbirds have been able to win a game and take a shot at the top seed here this afternoon in the semifinals.
And now the defensive decisions for Wichita State. You cannot help off of Tyler Brown. You absolutely have to shadow him. You've got to flatten out, take dribble penetration away from the point guard for Illinois State, Nick Moore, number one.
Jackie Carmichael has another double-double. 12 points, 11 rebounds today. Smith, a double-double. 14 points, 13 boards for Wichita State. Here we go. Brown, too high off the glass. He tries to get it back. It's out of bounds.
When Tim Jankovic
wanted
the foul call.
He wanted it.
But I sure like the attack action of Illinois State.
All right, 18.1 seconds to go. No shot clock. Timeout. That's the last one for Illinois State with 18.1 to play.
You want to know your personnel, put them in a position for success. Moore is the guy that can make the play to win this game. Not make the shot, but make the play to win this game.
Tyler Brown to inbound, and it goes to Carmichael.
There he is.
Moore against Demetric Williams. Brown at the free throw line. Into the lane. Off-balance shot. He's fouled with 6.4 seconds to go. The foul is on Williams, his third. Two shots here for Tyler Brown. And Brown today is 2-for-2 from the line, 77% for the season. This is for the tie. How calm and cool was that?
Extremely.
Here's Stutz coming back in, replacing Carl Hall.
Greg Marshall wants a timeout.
Greg Marshall gets that.
Country half, either tie or down one. And if I'm Tim Jankovic, I'm going to sell out to make sure Joe Ragland never touches the basketball.
We talked about the depth of the Shockers and the toughness of their team. We're going to see that right here. One more free throw for Tyler Brown. He's shooting for his 25th point. And the lead. Count it.
Tim Jankovic now subs in a better defender. Anthony Cousin now comes off the bench.
6.4 to go. Illinois State by one. And here's Wichita State down the stretch. Murray. He missed it. And it's out of bounds to Wichita State with 0.9 on the clock. Wichita State wants the timeout. One timeout left, and Coach Marshall just used it. With 0.9 on the clock.
Watch the clock here. The clock does not start immediately. And watch when the ball goes out of bounds. With 1 second to go. Now the question is, if the clock did not start immediately, then you've got the time in real time exactly how long it took before the clock started.
And that's why my partner pulls out the stopwatch.
And you time it in real time. Watch it from the beginning with 6.4 seconds. See if the clock starts in real time upon possession. Picks it up right there. There's a little bit of a delay there, and the officials are going to make a determination if there was enough of a delay to go ahead and monitor that and evaluate it through handheld at the scorer's table. It shows 1 second to go when the ball goes out of bounds. It shows 0.9 right now on the clock. He picks it up. The clock doesn't start, it appears, for some period of time. If we could run that in real time, then we can go ahead and time that.
So the officials look at the monitor over at the official scorer's table, and they're trying to determine what to put up on the game clock.
There was a small delay. It's less than 1/10 of a second, the way I got it.
Is what they've determined.
There you go. That's a great job of officiating right there.
I think staying on top of the game. I think they've done
reviewing it.
Great job managing this game today with the physical play, the technical fouls. Wichita State still has a timeout left because of the stoppage in play. No timeout was called or charged to Wichita State. 1.1 on the clock. Here we go, Mark.
Stutz is a huge target inside with 1 second to go. He has a big size advantage over John Eakey. There he is.
He gets the shot away, and the Redbirds have upended the 14th-ranked Wichita State Shockers. Led Illinois State to its 20th win and an upset of Wichita State, 65-64, Mark.
Illinois State only has one avenue to the NCAA tournament, and they're in the fast lane right now. And Wichita State, the number 14 team in the country, will wonder what if, but this is a very good seed NCAA Division I team.
Well, hang on. There's more to come from St. Louis. Our second game today, Creighton against Evansville. About a half hour from now, March Madness here at Scott Trade Center. The final score in game one, 65-64. Illinois State beat Wichita State. For Mark Adams and our entire Missouri Valley Conference television crew, we hope you enjoyed it. I'm John Rooney saying so long for St. Louis, so long for just a while.